to Riverside National Cemetery. My name is Edna, your cemetery representative for the service. And on behalf of our director and our staff, we would like to offer our sincere condolences to you all for the loss of your life. To say that we're so very honored that you chose the Riverside National Cemetery as your honor and final resting place. Now, before we turn the services over to the honor team, we ask if you have cell phones or any other electronic devices, if you could please place them on silence at this time. However, you can take as many photos, videos as you want. Thank you. We now turn the services over to the honor team.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today's military honors will consist of the sounding of taps, followed by the folding presentation of the American flag to you, sir. Today, as we honor Mr. Higgins, Lieutenant of the United States Navy, there's any amongst us that have served honorably during the sounding of taps, please render one form of hand salute for our fallen comrade. All others, you may respectfully place your right hand over your heart. At this time, if you are able, please stand.
Bugler! Sound taps!
Thank you.
now concludes military honors. Honor guard, left face. For march.
My brothers and sisters, we believe that the ties of friendship and affection which knit us together as one throughout our lives, they don't unravel with God. We're confident that God always remembers the good we've done and forgives our sins. Let us ask God to gather to himself. Thomas Polk has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. And with faith and hope and eternal life, let us continue to assist him with the prayers. And let us pray to the Lord for ourselves. May you, as family and friends who mourn, be reunited one day with Tom, and together may we meet Christ Jesus, when he who is our life appears in glory. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you sanctified the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that Tom's remains may sleep in peace here with his wife Gail until you awaken them to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then they will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. I assume that you're getting ready for the holy day on Thursday evening, getting ready for your Passover meal. No? How many Jews are you not getting ready for Passover? We know that our Christian faith is grounded in the Jewish faith. Our scripture, half of our scripture, is dedicated to the history of the Jewish people, who they were, where they went, what they did. We have their law, the book of Deuteronomy. We also have some of the lyrics to their songs. And I know you're going to be happy. I'm not going to ask you to sing. But I ask you to join with me in the chorus. Every song has a chorus, which is repeated, and every song has verses. So if you will join with me in the chorus, I'll leave the verses to you. And the chorus of the song is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me rest. Near peaceful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil will I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff, and these you give me. Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup is overflowing. Surely goodness and kindness will follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want." Pastor of my church, Pastor Higgins, was the pastor for 48 years. If you stop and think, a sermon or two a week for 48 years, that's a lot of sermons. And anybody who was in that parish for any length of time probably started hearing things over. And I realized that that's a liability that we as preachers have. Yes, we constantly need new materials. So I'm always looking in my environment for something to share. And I'm a big theater and film, so I often look in those environments for something special that I can work into a sermon later. And there was a particular play coming to the Amundsen Theater in downtown Los Angeles by a playwright that I always got something from. So I was excited. First act, nothing. Second act, nothing. And then a little irritated. I'm walking back to my car, and I glance over my left shoulder, and here on the side of the wall, one block long and 3 foot high letters, was this saying: in this world, there's kind of a painful progress, longing for what we've left behind and a dream ahead. And I literally have the step back moment, because that's our whole Christian theology of death and resurrection. In this world, there's kind of a painful progress. This is a tough journey we take. Hard. Anybody who thinks we get out of this world unscarred is delusional. In fact, I would like to have words with whoever coined the phrase, the golden years. Are you kidding? This is the rusty years. This is tough. But if our Christian teaching teaches us that when we are baptized, we share Jesus' death. That's the concept, that we go into the tomb and share his death. So that, as Paul tells us, likewise, we share his resurrection. So there's that journey ahead, that journey forward, that journey back to the source of life from which we came. But it's a tough journey, but it is a journey ahead. In this world, there's kind of painful progress, longing for what we've left behind. There's not any of you here today that haven't had an infinity of pictures of Tom in your life. Way back, weddings, celebrations, Christmas, those moments of the past that we've left behind. And we long to go there. I'm from Colorado. I used to climb mountains. I couldn't climb the steps these days. And I long for where I've left behind. But here's the secret: the dream ahead. Our prayer. Lord, for your faithful people, life is not ended. In the body of our earthly dwelling lies in death, we gain an everlasting dwelling. That's what our faith teaches us. So the tears of sadness today, hopefully, are mixed with tears of joy. Tears of sadness are as partial. Tears of joy as joy. That's the good news. That's the gospel of the Lord. And if we can meditate, if we can focus on that just for a moment, stop and think. When he breathed his last breath, there was guilt. Welcome into the cave. Maybe with a little bit of. Took you a while. He's had a tough journey. Eight years without. 5 years. 2008? That's a long time to journey without his 64 years of partnership with God. But there, united again. So that's the tears of joy at his arrival. Sadness of his departure. Joy of your life. Now I have to end. Who've had mom and dad so long. You truly, truly, truly have been blessed to share so many events in your life's journey with me. By the time I was 25, I was my first one. And I know when I breathe my last breath, there they will be one. So just as much as Gail was there, and Tom breathed his last breath, there was that one, and Thompson. That's the good news. That's the gospel of the Lord, that it takes our faith to really turn those joys of sadness into joys of happiness. And if we consider this, that he's been pulled from your community, and it leaves a vacuum in that community, But he now finds himself in an entire new community. Comprising of all those people who went before him, all his law partners, all those people that he knew at work, all those people that journeyed with him in some way or another who went before him were there to welcome him to the Father's kingdom. How wonderful is that if you truly have love? And I have a little bit of good news. You can't really see it from here. Just right on the other side of that hill is our golf course. It's our golf course. So he's not far, heaven or earth, from his great love. And this is this was given to him by his father. What a wonderful is that? Something that has been with him this entire journey. So if we can have that kind of image of a new community, the new community where he finds himself, I like to call this place Riverside National Airport, because this is the kind of feelings we have when we go to see somebody off. Sadness at the departure, no question. The joy at the future that awaits them. So hopefully your tears mixed with joy, tears, sadness also. I have one other part. You won't find this in the scriptures. And I don't know too many other faith groups that teach this. This is my belief, but I'm really happy to say now that Pope finally agrees with me. I believe, like Will Rogers. Will Rogers used to say, there ain't no critters in heaven and I don't want to go. And I truly believe that all those little people in fur coats, part of our journey here on earth, and God will be part of our eternity. So just as much as Gail or Palmer and Tom Sr. were there, Shorty, you mentioned Jordy, and you guys didn't know Shorty. This was his dog out of his childhood, which shows you how important that he conveyed that to you somewhere along the line about his dog journey. There, I believe, absolutely. So this can be a day of joy, sure. Sadness of the departure, joy of the night. Take that prayer, and this is what a great week. This being Holy Week, Good Friday on this week and Easter Sunday. Tom has endured his Good Friday. Now he shares his Easter Sunday. So on Easter Sunday, be joyful in his passage from life to life. Here's the prayer. Lord, for your faithful people, life is not ended. It's just changed. And in the body of our life, we've grown, rise and death, we gain an everlasting joy and peace. That's the good news. That's the gospel. You have somebody you'd like to say a few things?
I just want to say that you're right. We were very, very blessed to have our parents for so long, and they were very good parents. And we're really happy to have them.
It was a great dad, and if all those animals are up there and there is some sand, I know we'll really have it. Anyways, we're all here because of him. Say huzzah, huzzah, and
another
golden day,
and another
golden
opportunity.
Because that's what he would say every Saturday morning. And he all gave us life. And
what was that little saying?
Huzzah, huzzah, another
golden opportunity. That's what he used to say.
That's the good news. I would invite you to join with me now as we pray to our Father in the words that our Savior has given to us. Please join with me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Soon we will go our separate ways. Let us take leave of Tom. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness. May it strengthen our hope. One day you'll joyfully greet him again in the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Trusting in God, we've prayed together. We now come to this last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in hope that one day you'll see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although this gathering of family and friends will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of the risen Christ. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to greet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, now take it to himself. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant to him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. To you, O Lord, we now commend the soul of Thomas Polk, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead, and in your sight, he lives forever. Forgive whatever sins he may have committed to human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask you this, in Christ's name. And let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish and the sorrow for when you are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. And may the love of God and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ bless us and console us and gently wipe every tear from our eyes. And we ask God's holy blessing upon us this day and forevermore.
The Graveside service here at Riverside National Cemetery. I would like to thank Father Connor for his prayers and for all of you for being here today. On behalf of Forrest Lawn and the Riverside National Cemetery, we thank all of you and our condolences go out to all of you. At this time, we are going to ask for the assistance one more time from the Catholic Church.